Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 1, knowing our numbers. And in that, children, we have already finished till exercise 1.3, that is related to estimation of a number. Today, children, we are going to do about expanding brackets. How will you expand brackets? Means how will you do multiplication of two numbers by expanding bracket? We can write a number which is related to 10, 100 or 1000, that we can write it in the form of addition of 10, 100 and 1000. Like if you have been given with 7 multiplied by 109, that we can write it in two ways. We can write 109 by expanding bracket like 100 plus 9. And then we can do multiplication. So here we were using certain rules, and by following that rules we can do multiplication of two numbers by expanding brackets. So now here we'll take few examples and we'll understand what do you mean by expanding bracket. See, first question, like 7 will be multiplied by 109. Now this 109 I can write it like this. I can write like this, 100 plus 9. After that, I was supposed to do the multiplication of this. Now 7 will multiplied by 100 as well as 7 will multiplied by 9. So this will become 7 will multiplied by 100 plus 7 will multiplied by 9. So this will become 700, and 7 9s will be 63, and the sum will be 763. So we have done this number, or that multiplication of a number, and this process or by this method we can make it a little bit more easier. Now you will say that it is not so much easier, but if you have any big number or any huge number, like here you have 2-digit number and then you have to do multiplication, then it will make your multiplication easier. Let's take one more example. If you have been given with such kind of an example, like both the numbers which are in the form of 100, both the numbers like 102, 102 multiplied by 103, 103. So we have this number 102 multiplied by 103. So we can write this number in this way. We can write this number 100 plus 2, that will be multiplied by 100 plus 3. So how we can do this multiplication? Now this one number will multiply by both. Now this 100 will multiply by this 100 also, and this 3 also. Similarly, this 2 will multiply by this 100 also and by this 3 also. And after that we are going to do the addition. See how we can do this. 100 will multiply by 100 plus 100 into 3, that will be 300, plus 2 into 100 plus 2 into 3, 2 into 3. So here that will become 10,000 plus 300 plus 200 plus 6. So what is the total here? 0, 5, 0 and 6. This will be your answer. So what we have seen in such kind of a question, expanding brackets means you will write a given number which is in the form of 10, 100 or 1000. You will change it in the form of 100 plus 2. 10 plus 4, 14 can be written as 10 plus 4, and then you can do that multiplication. 100 plus 2, 100 plus 3, and then they will multiply it with each other and then we'll do the addition. Now here 100 can be multiplied by 100 also. This only we have done. Then 100 will multiply it by 3, then 2 will multiply it by 100, and 2 will multiply it by 3. And then after multiplication we'll get this answer, that is 10,506. Which is your answer. And so children, this is one of your question. This is one of the example which I have taken, that how this expanded bracket will help you to find the product of two numbers. Expanding bracket or expanded bracket means you are writing a number in certain other ways and then you are doing that multiplication. So now children, I will take one more example which will help you to understand of this concept of expanding bracket. Now, might be you will be asking that, ma'am, why we were doing this kind of a multiplication or why we were writing in such kind of a form. So, this is a certain form of finding product of a number by simplifying it. You can simplify it in this way and then you can find out the multiplication. Now, let's take one more example like 17 that you are supposed to multiply by 109. As I was talking about this question only in the first question, where you will be having a first number is single digit number. But when you have a double digit number, two digit number, three digit number, then this method will make your work easier. Now here this will becomes, we can write it in this form, 100 plus 9. 100 plus 9, then this 17 will multiply by 100 plus 17 will multiply by 9. This will become 100 plus 7 9s are 63, 6 9 1s are 9, 6 15. Now we'll do the addition, 1853 will be your answer. 9 7s are 63, 6, 50. So 1853 is your answer of this question. So this we have seen few examples of expanding bracket. Expanding bracket and then you can solve it. So first of all we'll see questions related to this expanding bracket. And some of the questions we have seen here. And this exercise 1.4 is not there, but this expanding bracket, sums related to this expanding bracket you will be getting in the paper. Then this is the easiest method to solve it. So if anyone will ask that why we were writing in this form, then we'll say that this expanding bracket will help us to make the product easier. This is one of the method which will help you or which will make your product easier. Now we'll come to next. Next is Roman numerals. We'll come to Roman numerals. So Roman numerals you have already done in previous classes. Roman numerals that we have done in previous classes also. Roman numerals we have done in previous classes. First of all, introduction of Roman numerals. Roman numerals, that the numbers which will be written in the form of I, V, X, L, C, D, M. So I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, N stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500, and M stands for 1000. So first of all, you have to remember this I, V, X, L. I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, L stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500, and M stands for 1000. Now by using this, now, certain rules of Roman numerals. Certain rules of Roman numerals. From I, you cannot subtract anything. From I, you cannot subtract anything. From V, you can subtract only I. And from X, you can subtract only I. So, what do you understand that from I, you cannot subtract anything. From V and X, you can subtract only I, and from L, you can subtract X, but you cannot subtract this V. Fine? And you cannot subtract anything else. you can subtract only x. From C you can subtract x, but you cannot subtract L. From C and L you can subtract x. Then from D you can subtract C. Then from D you cannot subtract L or x. From M you can subtract C. So D and M, from D and M you can subtract only C. So subtraction rule, from IE you cannot subtract anything. From V and X you can subtract I. Now what do you understand by subtraction? When a number is written before a Roman numeral, that will be subtracted, and after a Roman numeral, that will be added in that number. A number or a symbol which is written before a Roman numeral, that is supposed to be subtracted from that. And if a Roman numeral written after that symbol, after a symbol, then that will be added in that. Fine. If I write I before B, so from B means 5. From 5 I will subtract 1, that will become 4. And this symbol, you can see this symbol is of 4. And if I keep on writing this I, so as many times, I cannot write it more than 3 times. I cannot be written more than 3 times. Means we can maximum number of times which I can write it I, that is 3. So I can be written only 3 times, maximum number of times which I can write it, that is 3. And I can only be subtracted from V and X. From V and X. If I subtract I from X, this will become 10 minus 1, this will become 9. And here also you can see this symbol, that is of 9 only. This symbol is of 9 only. Fine. So I hope this certain rules which I have tried to make it clear to you all. Now, what I have told you, that I'll summarize once again. Certain rules and how did you subtract. Now, I can be subtracted from V and X. Number two, from L you can subtract only X. L and C in both, you can subtract only X. Whatever you will write before a symbol, if before L I write X, so X is subtracted from it. Now what it will become? 15 is the symbol of L, minus 10, that will become 40. Now this XL is the symbol of 40. XL is the symbol of 40. Anything which is written before a symbol, that will be subtracted. And after a symbol, if I write LX, so this X will be added in L. This will become 50 plus 10. That will become 60. This will become 60. Fine. So, what you have seen, that Roman numerals, whatever written before a number, that will be subtracted, and after that number, that will be added to that number, whichever symbol will be given. So that is your Roman numeral. We cannot subtract I from L. From X and V we can. I can be subtracted only from V and X. From V and X you can subtract. From V and X you can subtract I. But from C you can subtract only X. X can be subtracted from X and C. From L and C. from L and C you can subtract X. So these are the certain rules of Roman numerals. Let's see how to write a number. We'll understand these rules again while taking some example. Okay, if you want to write 9, we'll start with the easier one first, 4. What will be the symbol of 4? Now we know the symbol of 5, that is V. We know the symbol of 5, that is V. Now from V you will subtract 1. So where I will write 1? I'll write before that. Then only it will be subtracted. So 5 minus 1, what it will be? That will be 4. Now we'll come to next. That is if you want to write 9. What I'll do it? What will be the symbol of 10? That is X. So from X we will subtract 1. This will become 9. What will happen if you have to write 11? 11. So in this 10, I will add 1. Means the number which is written after a given symbol, that will be added to that symbol. Means here 10 we have written, and after 10 I have put it 1 standing line. So it means 1 will be added in this 10. That will become 11. Now we come to next, like 12. So after X we will add 2 more. Now what will happen if I have to write 15? So what I do? X and then this V. That will become 10 plus 5. That will become 15. 10 plus 5. That will become 15. Then 21. 2X and 1I. That will be 21. What will happen if you have to write 30? How will you write 30? Then we write 3X. That will be 30. Now X cannot be written more than 3 times. Any symbol in this Roman numeral cannot be used more than 3 times. Like X you cannot write it more than 3 times. I you cannot write it more than 3 times. Like 13 after 13 then we have to write 14. So 4 will be written as IV. 4 will be written as IV. So any symbol cannot be used more than 3 times. That is the basic rule of Roman numeral. So let's write few big number. What will happen if you have to write 49? First of all, 40. How will you write 40? That I have told you just now. How will you write 40? So from 50, what is the symbol of 50? That is L. From that you will subtract 10. Since I have told you that 10 will be subtracted from L and C. 10 will be subtracted from L and C. So XL will become 40. XL will become 40. So what will be the symbol of 45? That will be XLV. XLV. What will be the symbol of 50? That we are knowing L. And what will happen if you have to write 60? So that will be LX. Now this X means after that symbol of L we have written X. So this 10 will be added in this. So that will become 50 plus 10, that will be 60. Then 70. L, X, X, that will become 70. 80, that will be L, X, X, X. Now children, as I told you that you cannot write any symbol more than 3 times. So after 80, how will you write 90? So for writing 90, what I do, from 100 I will subtract 10. C is the symbol of 100. So from that we will subtract X. So what will be the symbol of 97? That will be XCVII. XC means if any symbol is written before any bigger one. So that will be subtracted from that bigger number. And VII means 7. So that will become 90 plus 7. Let's take one more example. If you have to write 99. So we'll write XCIX. 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 So that will be there, your Roman numerals. Let's see some of the big now Roman numerals also. Big Roman numerals. How will you write it? See, I have told you what will be the Roman numeral for 500, that is D, and for 1000, that is L. So for writing huge numbers, like if you have to write 548, that also we can write easily. For 500, you can use that symbol and then we can add the other one. So let's write huge number after 100. So if you have to write 162, for 100 we have C and 60. How will you write it down? 60. So L is for 50 and plus 1, 60 II. So L is 50. If you will break it up, breaking up of that Roman numerals, and then you can write it. See how. Now 162 we can write it 100 plus 60 plus 2, and then we will write the symbol C plus L X plus 2. So that will become C L X and 2. C L X and 2. So that will be your symbol C L X and 2. That is 162. Now if you have to write it down, 198. See, this is the easiest way to write down any Roman numeral for any big number. If you have to write it Roman numeral for 190, that will become 100 plus 90 plus 8. So we can write it C. 90 is what? XC plus 8 is VII. That will become C XC VII. That will become Roman numeral for this 198. So this is the exact method or the accurate method when you are supposed to write it Roman numeral for any number. Whenever you have to write Roman numeral, let's say here I change it. If I have to write Roman numeral for 245, if I take it 245, how will I write this? 200 plus 40 plus 5. So then I am going to write the symbol for this. This will be CC plus 40, that will be XL and V. This will become CC XL V. This will become CC XL and V. Roman numeral for this given bigger number 245. So like this you can write Roman numeral for any number. Smaller number also, if you have to write it like Roman numeral for 73 or 373, then also. Basic rule, you will not use any symbol more than 3 times. If you are using C also, like 300 you are writing, and then that 300 you are also not using 300. C, you are not going to use more than 3 times. So if I have to write 373, how will you write it? First you expand that number and then use a Roman numeral for each symbol. 373. So this can be written as 300 plus 70 plus 3. So this will become C. 70 is N X X plus 3. This will become C N X X 3. So this will become your symbol for 373. 373 can be written in this form. 373 can be written in this form. Now let's take one more example, 498. How will you write 498? We write 400 plus 90 plus 8. So this will become 400 will become. Now, as I told you, you cannot write any Roman numeral more than 3 times. So how we will write this 400. So we'll subtract C from D plus 90 is X, C plus 8. So what will be the symbol here? C, D, X, C and 8. C, D, X, C and 8. C, D, X, C and 8. So children, let's revise what are the basic rule of Roman numerals and expanding brackets we have already done. Expanding brackets, when a number, a multiplication which is given in the form of 10, 100 or 1000, then how will you find it out? 10, 100 and 1000, then how will you find it out there? It's multiplication. How will you find it? It's multiplication. Then you will expand that number by using expanding brackets, by writing it in the form of 10, 100 and 1000, and then you can multiply it. So that is your expanding brackets and then Roman numerals. Now Roman numerals is what Roman numerals means. When we were talking about Roman numerals tell you the way to write a number in the form of Roman numerals. We use certain symbols for writing the given Hindu Arabic number in Roman numerals. Now these numbers like 373, 498 is known as Hindu Arabic numerals. That is, Arabic people when came in India, then they introduced these numbers to us. So that is known as Hindu Arabic numbers. So we were writing Hindu Arabic numbers in Roman numerals. So for writing Roman numerals, we have certain set of rules. We are using certain symbols. I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, L stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500 and M stands for 1000. After that, if you have to write it 373, what you are going to write? Any symbol will not be used more than 3 times. Any symbol is not used more than 3 times. Second thing, that the maximum number of times you can use the symbol, that is 3. After that, I can be subtracted only from V and X. You cannot subtract I from L. So from L and C you will subtract only X, and from D you cannot subtract X. Then from D and M you will subtract C. If you want to write it like 900, then what you will do it? You will subtract C, 100 from 1000, that is L. And then you will write rest of the numbers. So that is your Roman numerals rule. First of all, any number, any symbol will not be repeated more than 3 times. Maximum of 3 times it can be repeated. And then a bigger number will be subtracted from a smaller number. If I write any smaller number before a bigger number, like here I have written XC, means X is subtracting from C. From 100 you will be subtracting X. And then 8 or whatever. Now in 8 also you can see I will be repeating only 3 times. And if you want to write 9, you will subtract I from X. So children, this is your Roman numerals. Almost each and every introduction of Roman numerals we have done. And what we have discussed in this whole chapter, that you can find it out in this summary of the chapter. Now children, chapter 2 we will start in our next class, that is whole numbers. What do you mean by whole numbers and how will you find it out that whole numbers? That we will discuss in our next class, and we will find it out that how will we find it out predecessor, successor and in fact the number lines, and how whole numbers are different from natural numbers. That also we will see in our next class. So today we have finished with our chapter 1, that is knowing our numbers and all the concepts that is related to knowing our numbers, that is our large numbers that we have finished. Large numbers concept, Roman numerals, expanding brackets, estimation and international system of writing numbers. Everything we have finished. Now we will start chapter 2. In the next video, that's all for today, children. Have a good day.